And all the ladies sing. And all the ladies sing. Think I like that. And all the ladies sing.
Let me get up and dance.
Uh-oh. You're the first one that wanted to dance. Like.
Wait.
Okay, let's go.
No.
Go. Okay. You're too funny. What's up, man. Brian? How are you? Did you hurt your neck?
I think I just sprained the muscle.
No.
Sprained the muscle trying to.
You were doing too much.
Yeah. Got to ease into the week.
That is hilarious. Welcome to Champagne and Conversations, guys. This is Brian Young Creative, and we were having much fun behind the scenes. Sorry. We're running a little bit late, but here we are.
It's COVID times. Are we really late, though? In time relative?
True enough. And I love the fact that we're twinning right now. This was so not planned, guys. So please don't think so. He logged on.
We chuckle. Just not planned. I get clowned about my fedora collection, my scarf collection, my watch collection. And, you know, it's kind of brisk out here in Detroit and with no hair. So I had to break out the scarf. So we didn't plan this.
We didn't plan this, but we're twinning. And then I also have, I show you guys that I have my Always Bet on Black t-shirt. Yay. So thank you so much for this.
Thank you.
I love it. And while we're talking about that, I want to make certain that you do share the website with us. So before we get off of here, we can share the website and all that good stuff. And, you know, you can give us the information so they can shop for the holidays, the few days that we have left in 2020.
Yes.
Before we go too far, because you have had me to wait till 7 o'clock to have my glass of champagne today. So we have to open our bottles.
Yes. And, I kind of went overboard. So, I got, not one, sound like LeBron James, not two, but maybe three. So I don't know which one.
Are we really going to have like that long of a line? Is that what you're planning?
No, it's just been a day.
I hear you. Well, listen, we're going to open our bottles, guys, and then we're going to toast to the long day, and you can talk about it. Feel free to do so.
All right, now. Well, let me make sure I don't put my eye out while I get
you
this
did say that.
Unscrewed.
You warned me, and then look what you're doing.
Woo!
Look at that.
Oh!
Woo! That's a party.
Yeah.
That is a party. And I said that was going to be the possibility.
You warned me.
I know you're new at this, but it's usually the party.
Yeah, I'm not a champagne connoisseur, but I am a connoisseur of anything that is alcohol. So
and good.
That's the difference. That's the difference.
So, champagne and conversations is always good. So we're going to make certain that you enjoy yourself. And I'm a little jealous that you got all of those bottles. But I mean, you know, it is what it is. Have a good time.
You should see my liquor stash. So, or I should say, it's mine. it's mine. But
the glass is fancy.
Hey, you know, I could have broke out the red solo cup, but nah, it's not that type of thing. No.
We got our scarves on. We got our Always Bet on Black.
Ma'am.
We need you to be a little more classy today, not the solo cup.
Exactly.
Now, cheers to you. Oh, you haven't even poured yours. I told you had. Watch it. You are having a ball. Cheers.
All right. Cheers, my sister.
Hey. Mm. Oh, that's good.
Oh, yeah.
I needed that. I've been waiting on that all day. You know, I'm normally on early. So now we're in the evening hours. So this is like, yes, we have to be able to just have a good time.
And I have to apologize for that. And I have to extend my thank you for being later, but one of the things that I forgot about. I'm mentoring some high school students, and
nice.
And so they're myself and other professional designers around the area.
Okay.
It's called the Michigan Design Council. So they partner up professional designers in the predominantly in the suburban Detroit area with high schools, age students, and as far down as K through 12. And so they come up with a project, and then us professional designers will sketch it out. And I totally got the dates wrong. I thought the banquet ceremony was tomorrow. And then my colleague's like, yo, man, it's Tuesday. And I'm like, uh-oh. So, yeah, so that'd be there. And I have to say that my kids, they placed third. So with their idea. So, but
that's what. We'll cheers to them.
Oh, well, maybe that's why I got three bottles.
Maybe that's why.
for my
we have to move you right along then so you can get through them. Yes, well, congratulations. That's always such an amazing feeling, you know, to be able to give back and support and watch the creativity of the young people. As I explained to you, my tech is that, and he is just blossoming into his own. So we do love to encourage the young people.
Exactly.
Yes,
you know,
that's great.
If we, you know, it always amazes me because you put yourself in their shoes, you know, you whoever you run across in your walks of life. And I didn't know who these kids were.
Okay.
Like, so we were paired. So obviously with COVID, you know, we were, I met them and their parents through a Zoom. And then I'm like, oh my God, these are three high school age young ladies, teenagers who want to follow, maybe not in my footsteps, but you know, to be a designer. And from my experience, I'm like, wow, whatever I can do to encourage them, to help them. Because I'm thinking back when I was in high school, I had a counselor who was just like, yeah, you want to go to trade school and we won't get it. I'm like, nah. I want to be a designer. I know art school. He's like, no. You don't need to do that. And so I'm thinking, fortunately I had a mother who like really helped me.
Yeah.
Back then. But outside of that, any mentors or any adults that could have helped guide me would have went a long way. So if I could do that for these young ladies, especially, you know, the
That's
discrepancies in minorities.
Sure.
Women in all industries and all genres, you know.
Right.
So, but yeah,
that's amazing that your guidance counselor encouraged tech. In my high school, they discouraged tech. So as to where I wanted to do tech, because when I started in the cosmetology world, that was not a respected kind of career, if you will. It was just Botec. So it was just, okay, what do you want to do?
Oh,
with it?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I had to champion, wait, hairstylists, makeup artists can make the same amount of money as an attorney or otherwise, but they weren't
hearing me.
Yeah, they weren't hearing me. Yeah. They were like, oh, girl, listen, you got a scholarship. You're going to Hampton University. Forget about it. And I was like, no, not so much. I think I want to be in New York. I think I want to do something different. They're like, no, not so much. So that's amazing that they even were encouraging the tech part. I know that might not have been your thing, but for me, they weren't giving it to me at all. So congratulations that you were able to, whatever career it was that you sought after, that you were able to get into that.
Yeah. I think the path that we've been given, or I should say the path that we've all gone down, you know, and this is not something big and major, but it's that saying that, you know, it's no surprise to God. So, you know, everything
Absolutely
happens,
not.
You know, so, you know, I've always wanted to be a designer and I've gone away from that and yet come back to it. So even back in high school and in grade school and you know, there's moments where I flirted with other careers and other, but it wasn't my passion.
Yeah, so, that's it. That is it.
Yeah. So.
And now you wanted to be a designer in its entirety, or specifically for vehicles?
Cars, specifically for cars. Yeah, because I've got
That's different. Well, different to have that interest.
Yeah. You know, well, you know, because the common thing is that most people will just, I heard this growing up, oh, you should go to engineering school. You should go to engineering school. And, you know, even before I knew about art school, I knew that that wasn't it. And so I always drew. I was always sketching and drawing.
Okay.
And I love cars. I don't know how to, you know, so I always wanted to design cars. And then, you know, as I got older and won art contests in grade school, I remember this one that I was I'm competitive. I remember my oldest, who's 13, when he was about, I say maybe 9, and he beat me at Nintendo Wii boxing. And he started it.
That was so funny.
Girl, I was like, oh, you want to go there?
Yes,
you really want to go there?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Next, I whipped his ass. And
Nintendo then my sister Wii caught was on so video. Fun.
So I'm competitive. So I remember losing a Black History Month art competition.
Uh-huh.
And then I was fifth grade. And I was like, all right. Next year came around, I was in sixth grade. I was like, you know, in my kid mind, I'm like, I'm nailing this contest. Yeah.
It's on.
I don't care, man. And so, yeah, I kicked butt. I came in first place. I did this charcoal drawing. I think it was Frederick Douglass. And I think my mom still has it somewhere. But yeah, but art has been in me. Design's been in me. And so, yeah, I've always wanted to be a car designer, but by the grace of God, I've, you know, it's allowed me opportunities in other areas.
Sure. You know. Yeah. That's when you turn your passion into purpose, that's what happens. The walk expands. Now, with that being said, guys, Brian Young Creative, we have him on the show and we are so excited to welcome you to Champagne and Conversations. A sidebar, as he would say, is that I asked him to design an ugly Christmas sweater and add that to the collection. I tried. He didn't quite do it, so I guess that's how the scarves came about today.
I can do it, sister, but you know, if I cut out sleep.
He just was like, I'm just so busy. So we didn't get the ugly Christmas sweater vibe, but at the end of the day, we do have a nice collection in which I do have one of the items on, which is Always Bet Black. So I want to make certain that you share with us your information, your website and Instagram and all that great stuff.
Absolutely. So pretty simple. I'm a pretty on some things pretty simple guy. So website where anybody can go and check out and hopefully purchase any of the apparels is BrianYoungCreative.com. And my Instagram name is the same, BrianYoungCreative.com. I'm pretty, you know, there's so much going on in the world. You know, I keep it simple.
Keep it simple, stupid.
Yeah, exactly. Hey, that was rule number one in art school.
Kiss it.
Yeah,
that's it.
Exactly.
So what was the inspiration behind the amazing designs? Because you've kind of broke that out into phases, it appears.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I swear, man, you're about to make me jump out the seat. You are seriously the one of the first people that has caught on to that. So, you know,
branding, we got it. We got it. We're here. We got it.
So, the simply put, in like 2 seconds, the inspiration, or it began with my kids. And from there, it's just kind of grown. It's one of those happy accidents. So, you know, we started with Black Panther inspired apparel.
Okay.
My interpretation of Black Panther, and then that's evolved, and there's more coming. So we've just had to slow it down. One, because a lot of customers who I don't consider customers, I consider everybody family, truly. So. I'd get people like, yo, man, I missed it. You know, when is that coming back? I'm like, okay. I got a lot of that. And then
that's because the way you teased it, you did that.
Oh, yeah.
You gave everybody a week. Listen, you got 5 days and 2 hours to get it or it's gone. So that's why you got that.
Well, Hey, you know, ain't no CP time over here. You got to get boom and boom.
That's right. That's right.
But part of that was because of the you know, what that inside baseball, the behind the scenes, working with shipping and vending and supplies. And so I'm like, okay, well, we can only do this for this amount of time. But yeah, but the inspiration was started with my sons, and then it kind of snowballed from there, where, you know, I'm looking around and getting inquiries about, hey, you know, Brian, you know, a lot of people don't know I do photography. A lot of my photography is, I haven't posted any of that, and I haven't shown any of that.
Creative, hence the word creative. We got it.
Yeah, I don't sing. So don't get that. That's
I do. I do. Girl. I didn't say it would be in tune, but I can sing.
Well, if I kill a couple of rap, bottles, dance, then we'll see.
One show, I can do it.
All right, now I could get out some cardboard and break dance, and then probably
let's
be in the
it.
ER
let's
later.
Do it. Move the chairs back. This is what it's about. It's 7 o'clock. Nobody's judging you. Go.
Let me go get my Kango.
But, if that's what it takes in this day and time, right? Just to be able to boost off for a moment.
For real. Yeah. And get rid of some of these COVID pounds. So we won't
go there.
I don't
know what to say about that. Yeah, we won't go there, because this in and of itself is enough. So I don't know what to say about that. We can't talk about that.
This is healthy, right? Because this comes from berries and grapes, and this is the excuse I tell myself.
As long as it tastes good, it's all that matters to me. At the end of the day, it has to be something that we go right. It's
you,
all right.
You done got me a new favorite, because I'm going with I consider myself halfway worldly. I've lived in other parts of the world and traveled, but my pronunciation of things is kind of off at times. Segura.
Uh-huh. Am I saying that correctly? And that's a Spanish one. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, no wonder. See, I fail Spanish. So.
Segura. Uh-huh. You fail
years.
Spanish?
Yeah. I repeated, I think it was Spanish 2 in high school. And my teacher was a friend. So it was kind of hard to be in class. Like, hey, what's up, Robin? She's like, that's Miss Hill to you. I'm like, whatever.
Oh, well, no wonder you didn't pass. You had other agenda. So that was that was that.
No.
You had another agenda. That was a different inspiration, Brian.
Yeah.
No need to focus on this part. I got that.
Life does not have a rearview mirror, because we're looking forward, not backwards. So,
okay, no. So you had goals.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah. So now, as you were just, we kind of got off, but
I'm sorry.
You were talking about the first of the collection, which was the Black Panther inspiration. But now you have several with just different sayings on those. So I wanted to make certain that you got through those, just in case anyone was curious about the different collection.
Yeah. Well, yeah, absolutely. So, you know, we've kind of broke, the original intention was not to focus on the Panther inspired line. This was all a setup for my artwork, which is predominantly automotive based, as one subsection. And then the other subsections, what I felt was just Black affirmation. And that, again, that came about as I look at my sons. And as they grow up in this world, and my stepchildren as well, I hate calling them step, but you know, so all total they're six. You know, you got
bonus
five boys.
Children.
Yeah, bonus children. And so, you know, the unfortunate negative connotations that are associated with Black. It makes me squirm in my seat right now. So, you know, I'm thinking, like, why is it that Black is perceived and felt as negative in certain situations? And so Black is beautiful, which is, which is, to me, these are not like earth shattering, but I wanted to remind people in a visual statement, you could be walking around and have Black is Beautiful, Always Bet on Black. And Always Bet on Black is something I've said internally for years. And I look at like in our political climate, I may have mentioned this at some point recently, but I was I reminded people that, you know, our Black women are the ones that constantly are saving democracy. So, you know, Always Bet on Black, duh. And then like one of the more recent ones, Black is not a crime. Like, dude, I can't, you know, I'm going to keep this light, but let's just say I've had my fair share of being profiled while, you know.
Really?
Yeah, in any situation. I've had, you know, whether when I was, the jacked up thing is a good friend of mine, when I was in art school, I have a very diverse crew of friends and come from a diverse family. So I may say dude a lot, then I may say bruh a lot. I'll introduce whether it's my white friend or my Indian friend. Hey, this is my brother, this is my sister. Because that's how I feel. That's how I genuinely feel towards our fellow human beings. So one of my sisters from college, Pam, it's messed up. She reminded me of a time I got detained by the police when we were in college that I had forgotten about. So I'm like, Oh yeah. I forgot about that one. And then for the rest of that day, I was like,
Set off.
I was like, and what was it? I went to the bookstore. They stopped me walking in the parking lot, going to my car. Do you have a driver's license? I'm walking. Do I need a walking license? I mean, so, you know, there's countless encounters, being pulled over when I had a nice car, being pulled over when I had a crappy car. Most recently when my two older sons are living in another state, I every 2 weeks, like clockwork, I take off early, drive, pick them up, bring them back here. And recently I got profiled because the cop didn't believe that my sons were my sons, because they're multi-ethnic. So my oldest really has the white characteristics of his mother. And I'm sitting up here, and that just stuck with me. Like, dude, we're literally in the convenience store. Black is not a crime. I do not, you know. So anyway, sorry to get off on a tangent, but
this is fine. Yeah. Listen, that's why you got your bottles. We had this all planned. You can just get it all out. It is fine. I mean, But it is unfortunate that you're saying as such. And now, what was the response of your children to the questions that were being had about you and the, I mean, did they think you were like abducting these children?
It's about a 2.5 to 3 hour drive. Well, when it's just me, but it's driving to get them, coming back is longer because we stop frequently. But no, I don't think they were aware. They were just oblivious because, you know, they're running through the store, just get some chips or candy or whatever. And I was so tired. I'm usually good with keeping my head on a swivel. I think my oldest, he's 13. I think he may have thought so. He didn't say anything to me, but this cop came out of nowhere, and it was a quick interaction. I mean, luckily, he's like, but to think that I was so tired, and it dawned on me, I'm like, holy crap, where am I? I didn't even remember. Yeah, you know, I'm trying to take stock of, where am I? Where are my three kids? Here's a cop who has his hand, you know, can I see your ID? And I'm like, what for? Whose kids are those? They're my children. Where are your ID? And I said, I politely said, officer, I'm not giving you my ID. What, my son, he's 13. He doesn't have ID. How are you going to, you know? And then I think my middle or youngest had called dad. And then the cop, then I could read his body language where he shifted, where it's like, oh, maybe this guy's, you know, this is my interpretation.
Wow.
And then he just like, well, and then he said, well, you know, somebody could be kidnapping kids, or, you know, just whatever the excuse may be.
I don't want anybody's kids that are not mine. I mean, I don't even really want mine sometimes.
Real talk. Sometimes.
And it's like, Christmas time. Lord. I don't want anybody to get no more kids. Yeah. No.
So, girl, yeah.
I love them all, man. But they can stay at home on that holiday. No.
Sometimes parents need a break.
Absolutely. He's thinking somebody's going to take some children. This, I mean, although in all fairness, we do know for those folks that would be watching to say, oh, there are people to take the kids. We get it. I understand that.
But I get it.
Yes, we know that that could be. But in this sense, obviously, it was innocent. And why? I mean, you know.
It was just out of left field. And so, you know, in that moment, and it took a while, that kind of, that soured my weekend.
Where were you? What were you in Detroit still?
No, I was. I know I was in Ohio, and I've no longer taken that route to get my kids. Cause for whatever reason, Waze takes me from Detroit south into Ohio, and then west into Indiana. My older kids are in Indiana, and so it's the quickest route. But the flip side of that, it's like, you know, one of those old style highways or expressways that you're taking, and you know, kids say, hey dad, you know, we want some soda or something. So I, you know, I'm tired. I was like, I need to stop anyway, I got my kids. And I just pull off, and I saw the sign that said gas station. I didn't even realize what town. So yeah, so you know, things could have gone sideways, but by the grace of God, I was kicking myself. I contacted some of friends and said, hey, now I'm really kicking myself. I know what I'm supposed to do. You know, badge number. It just went out the window. It just went out the window. And I'm like, because in the split second, I'm thinking, yo, where am I?
Yeah.
Wait, my oldest, I saw him go to the bathroom. My two other sons are over here. I got this white cop in front of me with his hand on his gun asking him. And so I'm like, only thing I could do is like, sir, I'm not going to give you my driver's license. What for? What, you know, these are my kids. Why do I have to prove? And things, simmered down. As we walked out, I saw him in a squad car just eyeballing me. And I'm just like, ugh. So yeah, I no longer take that route, but that's a moment where it hit me of like, black is not a crime. Me just standing here, a lot of us people of color, just existing is not a crime. And so that led into, you know, one of our black affirmation apparel, and then and there's a couple more that are coming, so we're spacing them out. But
it would probably continue if you pay attention to it in that regard. I mean, you'll be developing things from now all the way through 2021. Like, girl, okay, here's another one. Well, that's, I mean, not that that is something positive in the sense of what we are experiencing as a people, but as it relates to your brand, you're able to expand it to things that people are actually, or can relate to, because they're experiencing it in some respect. It's unfortunate that was what you encountered. And in those small towns, obviously the ideology is still very different. I mean, we see it in the larger cities, but even in those rural spaces, you know, people are like one light, you know, one gas station, everybody knows everybody. So they see one thing come through that's strange. And then, you know, all of the sirens are off. Like, okay, who's this person and what are they doing?
Girl, I ain't tell you about when I moved to Iowa.
Well, one, I'm gonna need you to get off the Midwest coast, whatever that is. I need you to come in a little bit. That New could York, be why California, you're experiencing stuff. I need you to get to something a little bit more. You're in those places that are,
you know,
kind of had to fight to get them off of red. Okay.
Yeah, God's a comedian. So you know, and me, I'll give you the Cliff Note version.
God's a comedian, but he said he also gave you a little bit of sense.
Yeah. Brian, yo.
Yeah, like, bruh, what are you doing?
I know it's a well-paying gig, but really? Come on, man.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes, you cannot hang out at the Christmas party. You have got to go in.
Yeah. It's like, have you seen, we finally just saw what's the brother's name, Get Out, the movie Get Out. And and I won't spoil it for those that have seen it, but it wasn't scary like I assumed it was, but it was comical scary as a black man. I'm like, huh, oh, okay, yeah. So yeah, I want to make sure. Am I the only one at this Halloween party? Am I the only one at this Christmas party? Am I the only one? Okay, yeah, just be mindful. But yeah, God, I mean,
where you said you are, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. But that, you know, I've had faith, and don't get it twisted though. You know, common sense. Like, hey, all right, yeah, I need to be mindful of my surroundings.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yes, so that's good. That's good that you can identify that, yeah. and you're going to be safe. And but then you have the power around you, so that too gives you that extra intuition to be able to make an additional step if necessary. You know, in a direction that may not be detrimental. You know, just in case.
Girl. Well, I've done gone through, like, everybody's got their life story. And mine, I'm like, man, I've gone through so much stuff in my short little life on this planet that it does help. Like, unfortunately, the negative stuff I've done in my past before I was saved has helped me in my adult life of, like, knowing when, you know, I'm going to get back in the car and another gas station. Yeah, but anyway, that you asked one question, I went off around Mars, but
it's okay. You got to get it out. That's what this is all about. You got to be able to just let it go so that you can move on, because at the end of the day, you do have those gentlemen that you have to be able to rear, and luckily that they haven't all experienced the same things, because they may have different questions. It's, you know, if this is a situation for you, so some may identify one way, some other, you know, but at the end of the day, they're going to want to know, like, what was that about, or not, you know. So
I've had some we as a family wholeheartedly have had some conversations, and you know, around race and ethnicity and skin tone, and
welcoming light skin back.
Us light skin brothers, we coming back. Yeah,
we coming back. And now you got babies, and they definitely got to bring it back. So it's all good.
Yeah, girl, I remember. I remember. Okay, here's an embarrassing story. I think I may have shared this I don't know if I've shared this on any live or anything, but so I'm in high school.
I need it. Give it to me.
Oh boy. I'm in high school, and oh man, I just realized some people from high school are probably going to see this, trying to figure out who this is. So one neighborhood we lived in, my neighbor, she was, I think, a grade or two ahead of me. I think maybe I was a freshman, sophomore of high school. She was cute. And
once again.
And so,
and another girl, one.
So
okay,
I'm like,
keep going. Sorry.
So I'm gonna ask. You know, I was awkward. I don't know if I was awkward. It was like I wasn't popular. My family wasn't rich. We weren't like the. You know, I wasn't a jock. I ran track, but I didn't play football. Even though the coach was like, hey, you can make a good running back, and I was all like, I don't want to get hit. So I'm just gonna run track.
Okay, you're a late bloomer. Is what they call it. Late bloomer.
So I'd ask my neighbor. I worked up the nerve, like, I'm gonna ask her out, you know. And I got my license. I'm gonna, you know, I can drive. You know, hey girl, you want to go out? And I remember she was like, "Oh Brian, oh we've been neighbors so long. I'm honored, but I can't go out to you." And I'm thinking, okay, it's because, you know, I'm an underclassman. And she was like, "Oh, you're too light." I was like, "Oh," I was like.
What year was that?
That was '89, '90.
No, light skin was in then. What is wrong with her?
Not in Cleveland, where I grew.
Light skin was in the '80s, early '90s. We didn't get into the other until like mid '90s.
Maybe she was ahead of the curve, but man,
she said you're too light.
I remember I walked back and I asked my mom. I'm like, "Mama,
she
She's like, how'd it go?" She was, you know, mom. She was like, "That little heifer. You need me to go out?" I'm like, "No, no,
She headed out the door in her house coat. Where's she at? Where's she at?
We left that door to him, so.
You better be glad my son even wanted to talk to your daughter.
Yeah.
That's how that goes.
Oh my God. We don't believe I shared that. Yeah, but
it's okay. It's okay. You feel better now. Now you can.
Like I said, you know, life,
it lets it go. The champagne will always let it go. See, this is free therapy. Oh, shoot.
Oh, yeah.
Wait, he's going to finish one bottle. What? Listen, we might have to extend this live, guys. So just
be patient. No.
Just so he can like get it all in. Yes. No problem. Have a good time. Good. That's what we're here for. So I mean, in the spirit of holiday, just so that we get you know, have some exciting moments. Have you all started to decorate? Do you have traditions that you do during the holiday season?
Started to decorate, finally put up the tree. I didn't realize this was a tradition until last week that my mom started. Because, you know, a lot of people, especially in these times, you know, a lot of people have been putting up their tree and getting stuff ready. Like, I saw trees up around Halloween because this year has been so, difficult. Mm-hmm. And my mom... for those that don't know, my birthday was last Thursday on the 10th.
Oh,
my
happy belated.
Oh,
well, now I see why. Okay, so good. I don't feel bad. Oh. Cheers to this.
No.
I covered the birthday. Here we go. Cheers to that. Wait, Brian. But, it's not a shot. It's supposed to be a sip.
That was my sip. It's that was a southern sip.
That was a southern sip. Okay. All right. Continue.
You know, I was born down south, so yeah, that's a southern sip.
That was a southern sip. Go for it. Happy birthday. You want me to sing? Because I told you I can do that.
Oh, girl. Yeah, I won't put you on the spot.
Thank you.
But no.
I could make it happen.
The tradition, I guess, my mom would not put up any Christmas decorations until my birthday, till the 10th. And so that's carried over to me and our family.
Okay.
So we put up the tree at the earliest on the 10th. I think what's today, Tuesday? So I think it was Sunday.
Okay, so yes, the 15th.
Yeah. So yeah, that's a tradition. And we really haven't we're not finished yet. I'm my competitive streak comes out. Because I'm looking at my neighbors at the front doors the houses. I'm like, I've turned into Clark Griswold, where I'm like,
Electric company's best friend. Mm-hmm. It's just overdone. Like,
okay. All right. We got to get some more lights.
Wait, and are you one of those colored light people, or do you use those white pretty lights?
Ooh, we've alternated. Now my designer sense comes in, because I don't the Skittles. That I call them, where it's like
the colored lights, pardon the pun. The colored lights.
I'm like, they have to be the late
great
John Witherspoon. You got to coordinate. So, you know, you got to have at least the same hue or on the color wheel.
Yeah.
Over there, all the warms and then all the cool. And for, see, now my designer art nerdiness is coming.
I mean,
out.
Do you have icicles, and then you have like the reindeer in the yard and the big snowman and the carousel going with, I mean, is it reindeer? Is all that stuff going on too?
No, I've been banned from putting
You would do it too much.
Yeah.
Banned?
Yeah. Well, not formally, but you know, you get that like talk to where somebody comes up, put the show, say, bruh. Brian,
HOA?
Hey,
it's like, wait, you're doing too much?
This is great. So, we've had some complaints.
Really?
From who?
Right.
No, they're not complaints, but they're more like suggestions. Maybe if you could tone it down. Like, from who? Oh, boy that lost? Because I won last year.
It's a competition. I forgot. Dominion Power or whatever your power source is. Like, listen, you're using too much over here. Even though they should enjoy it.
No, the neighbors across the subdivision or on the other side of the main street. We drove in the other day, and these cats, I felt like they took it too far because they got all the trees that line the main street, which I think are technically city's trees.
Were you writing them a citation?
I'm like, word?
Not lawful. Really? I'm going to find out. I'm looking in the code book. This, you cannot do this. And I'm going to Target and I'm getting more light.
Yeah. So, but yeah, I keep all the lights. I hate that they're in their families. So they're color families.
Or is it all the same? Is it all white? I'm trying to get to that.
Okay. So, so for this year for the tree, it's
taking a long time to tell me. Do you have
it's all white, big
blue and green and red lights?
No, just we do like white or like the new LEDs that are kind of like that bluish white.
Okay.
And blue, because blue, I don't know, just it's calming. And
that's supposed to be like the crystal color. So I get that. I just wanted to see, I wanted to have a visual if you were doing like the entire rainbow or are we just, you know.
Nah. My mom did that. I'm like, this is my house now. Now I'm not a kid anymore. No, I want the tree to be like this. No. So yeah. No, it's all uniform.
Yes. And so listen, this is what I like. I'm gonna get
to know. Ooh. Better this Christmas. About to pull out my Ray Charles.
This is what I like. I have to have this. And I have to have that, and I'm good. I do have lights. They're all like amber lights, warm lights, so it's fine. By your side is and he has lights on here. Thank you, CB, for your great music. Yes?
Man.
Yes. So that's what I like. Christmas music. I like this.
Yes.
Friends, family, fellowship, and some good libations, good, you know, dinner of whatever sort. And, you know, thank goodness my kids are grown to whatever degree they think so.
Like, right.
I'm like, well, I have to do that other stuff. We'll have to sneak in Santa Claus and bite off the cookie and pour the milk and spill it. We'll have to do all that. And then they kind of come up with like, you don't have we don't have a fireplace. So how did he get in? I'm like, the front door.
And when we lived in a apartment, right after we moved up to Cleveland, and it was just me, my mom and dad. And I woke up early and my mom was like, stay in your room. And then, so I guess she had my dad go open and close the front door like Santa came in.
They're the worst. They're the worst. Trying to make, shh, you just dropped it. Be quiet. Like, y'all doing too much. Let me know when you're done. So I can come out.
See, so my little brother said, you know, I'm the oldest, and there's a big age gap between my brother and then my sister, who are about, they're a year and 3 days apart. So they had a partner in crime growing up.
Sure.
All my years, I never thought to do what they did when we were kids, where they, and I guess everybody else has probably done this, where they went, opened up the presents, ripped a little bit, see what they got, and then tried to tape it back up. But you
unbelievable.
Know, I'm like, really?
We didn't get that many. Why do you want to go cheat?
Yeah. So me, I'm just like, I will wait.
But, so did you ask Santa for something for Christmas this year?
You know what? You're seriously the first one that's asked me that. I've not really stopped and thought about what I want. I'm not trying to be, this is just how I am. I'm usually thinking, what can I get for other people? And like
guilty. I'm guilty. Yeah.
So, you know, for me, every year, well, I used to do this a lot and I had to stop because I felt like I probably needed to go to an addiction clinic or something. Cause I love watches. So every year I'd get a new watch.
What's your favorite? Now this is a good conversation. So what's the good watches?
Well, let's just say some are pricey.
Artemars. I mean, where are we going with this? It's fine because I watch them all. I do like the Breitling. I think that's a good, like, you know, kind of middle of the road.
All my years, I have not owned a Rolex yet. I don't know what it is. I've gone around. I've had
the presidential is probably not too bad right now. I mean, you know, and offline, I can probably tell you where to get that and really a great price. I think you're good.
But my watch collection got out of hand and I said this to one of my boys, I don't know how many years ago. And, you know, my friends who, you know, ride or die that we've been rolling for 20, 30 plus years.
Sure.
And I was like, man, you know, I had to sell some of my watches. And my one boy was like, some mofo, how many watches you got? And then I said, well, I had to buy another watch case. He's like, stop. When another, why, you bougie little. And I was like, I'm just saying.
Hey,
you know,
everybody's got a vice, right?
Right. But my watch collection ranges. Like I've got expensive ones, and I don't discriminate. If I see something that catches my eye, and that, you know, just speaks to me, okay. If it's $50, if it's $100, if it's got a comma in the price tag, it, as long as it's not breaking my bank too much, I will get it if it speaks to me.
Yeah, so, you're a designer.
So my range goes, there's one watch I've had for almost 18 years. And some people, some people are like, whoa, man, where'd you get that? And I'm like, dude, this is a Kenneth Cole with the third band.
It's called a classic piece. That's what that is. And being able to identify that is what makes it so amazing. So, I mean, maybe that's your next step, is that when you get into designing for your fashion line, then you will branch off into the watch space and merge with a brand and create some faces to the watch. We're going to just speak that into existence. Top of 2022.
All right now. You know, I did a ring. Years ago,
I think I heard you say that for someone that asked you to do one. Was it a diamond ring you designed?
Yeah, for his fiance, and I was like, and I just took it to a level where he was like, "Bro, I was just expecting some sketches." So I built I did the sketches, then I built a 3D CAD model in software, and then like milled out like a little 3D print, and he was just like, really? Like, dude, I was just expecting like some sketches, you know, so I could give it to the jeweler. I'm like, well, here, give him this. And then just paint my number.
This is complicated and he's not going to quite understand it, but give it to him. Let's see what happens.
But watches, I don't know. You know, you ever have so many ideas, not enough time?
No, I have not typically, but I will tell you that since pandemic has happened, anything that was of a desire because of the what we have in our hearts then became paper and then now is being worked on. So you just don't leave anything, like any stone unturned at this point. So I am, you know, kind of saying my 45 has been a great year. I am coining that at this point. It's just like he allowed for everything to slow down in order for us to speed up. And for me, it felt like that was the only way I could slow down, was for everything to slow down. In order for that to happen, I'm like, oh, wait, you mean to tell me no one is doing anything? I mean, like, wait a minute. No one?
We all are at the starting line.
Look, I was sprinting. Everybody else has slowed down. I'm sprinting. I'm gone. This is all I needed, was to be able to catch up, in essence, because it was just like so many things that you, like you say, you want to do, you're thinking about, you're working towards, and it felt like you were on a hamster on a wheel. You know, you're just constantly moving and moving, but you're not quite there yet. So in order to be able to maximize on where we are today, I'm like, yo, you did the wrong thing now to slow everything down.
I'm like, okay, watch me.
Like
watch
you just said, competitive. Listen, it wasn't against any one source. It was just me, like, go. This is it. That, like, go.
Yeah.
Like, that's it.
You compete, you know, compete with yourself, right? You know, that like, I remember, so I used to drag race back in the day. Gosh, seems like eons ago. But so one of the things that, like, my driving coach would tell me and tell us, like, you know, if you're drag racing, you know, that's like the simplest form. You're on the track, light turns green, quarter mile or eighth of a mile, but quarter mile, don't look at the driver next to you. Yeah, he's your competitor. Look at yourself.
Yeah,
you are your competition. You know, get down, you know, to the end of the line before the guy or girl next to you. And I don't know, that's something that's carried over to me, like when I went through school. Or if I'm working on, if I'm like bidding on a project, a potential client, or like even with this non-competitive project with the kids I was mentoring, I'm sitting up here like, oh, I'm competing. Okay, yeah, this is your assignment, but I ain't gonna let you lose. Yeah, so compete with yourself. You know, that's what
In a sense, I think that at this point, we understand what that fire, that desire is. And once you become in something called alignment this way, you know, anything that's going this way, and in that sense, allows for you to just go. So there, it's not so much as you feel like that. You just know that you're comfortable in your seatbelt. You're comfortable in your drive shift. And when you hit that pedal, it just feels good, right? And then from there, it's just like, what do we do? What do we do? Because as long as we are moving and what we are ordained to do, what our purpose is, it is nothing else that can cut us off at all, right? So at this point, it's just that. And so I think that it takes us a while to align in that regard, because we don't ever have time to sit in this space and be able to say in affirmation and in blessings, in gratitude and thankful. You know, you don't have that time because it's always a rat race, because you don't feel like I'm achieving what I'm supposed to be achieving, or I've met your goals or whatever. But this point, you can actually say, we created a clothing line, wasn't expected, but this is what we wanted to do. This feels good. We created four phases of it, went well, all lines sold out. Next year we have a whole different design. You know what I mean? So now you feel like, oh, that didn't feel too bad, right? Yeah. And now you're like, what else can we do? How else can we do this? And you have a different conversation for those folks that may still be in a little bit. Because, I mean, I said to one of my coaches the other day, I said, it's so many people going through things. And in my mind, I feel like I want to help everybody, because that's one of my... Right. You know, colors on my wheel is that blue, the helper. And she says, but there's so many that are still okay. And so I want you to be able to defer to that. And I was like, oh, that hurts. Like, I don't want to think about the people that are doing okay. I want to think about the people that aren't. But that's the thing. Like, we have to think about all of us that are still very healthy, that are very connected, that are very, know, driven, that are very, you know, clear on where we are and what we're doing. And we are thankful for those folks. And for that, you know, we look at it as.
But, you know, but I often say, I use the movie line from the first Indiana Jones movie, where the very first one, somewhere in there, and his crew thought Indy like had everything together, And he's like, I don't know, man, I'm making this shit up as I go.
As I go. Like, yes.
But he was confident in moving that. So, you know, we may not have it all together, but, you know, we have enough of it.
Who knows? That's the thing. Who knows when it's supposed to be and what it's supposed to be? No one else has sketched that out, if I may. Yeah. No one has sketched that but you. You know, and that's the thing, unless you've shared it.
And who is who is they that we are?
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. You know what I mean? So
well,
much.
They say I should have had my business launched. Or they say I should have. And, okay.
I'm bad for that.
We do need something that can push us outside or push us through and past our reservation or anxiety, especially now I'm about to get on my soapbox or TED talk or whatever, but we do need something to push us
past. Sip a little bit more.
Yeah. No, we do need something to push us past. Those things that are internal telling you not to pursue something, not to, if there's a book on your spirit, if there's a poem on your spirit, if there is, you know, if there's a business, if there's something as little as, or I shouldn't say little, but whatever somebody may deem little for them or big for them, if there's something that is holding you back, we got to be able to have somebody or something in us push us past that, to push us into that level of discomfort where you're like, oh man, I'm out here all alone. You know, I got this idea for a business. I've got this, the story I shared with you about me asking out my neighbor when I was in high school. You know, I'd been like crushing on her for a while, and then something in me, I didn't ask anybody. It was just my internal, like, pushed me out there, like, okay, oh crap, she's talking to me. Okay, I said hi. Something pushed, you know, I feel like we, not that they, but I feel like people in your circle who mean you good, not harm.
I was about to say people, the circle.
Yeah. People in your circle who have true intentions for you.
Yeah.
You should be okay with somebody said, hey girl, or hey bro, that idea you've been talking about for a couple of months or for a couple of years, what's stopping you?
And then I'm that person for all of my crew. They're all like, they can put it in downshift and coast for the next 20 years. Cause most of them have, you know, careers that allow for that. They're, you know, in a different type of, you know, career situation. I'm in entrepreneurship and the real form of it, like technically should be retiring soon from entrepreneurship. So at that point, I'm like, listen, I've been at this a lot of years.
But you're 25. So
wish. Yeah. Oh, thank you. Drink some more.
My mama raised me right. No, that just comes from my mama raising me right.
Well, bless her and you. And thank you. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year to her. But no, been a few years and have to experience, you know, several things. And even in this space, in this time, have had to shift in and out of some situations. So every day is a learning experience. Now, I will speak to what you stated about people saying or the naysayers. I mean, one, the theys. I am guilty of the theys because I've referenced them a lot. And everyone always asks me, who are the theys? And I'm like, well, everybody outside of this conversation, okay? It's the thing.
True.
That part. But outside of that, you know, I empathize, if you will, with those folks that do hear someone that is negative, because you don't want that in any kind of space that is already kind of discrediting or already discouraging right now, not as faith-filled or optimistic, if you will, as most people would like for it to be. Because, you know, people sometimes can only act upon what they see in reality, as opposed to being able to look past that with a vision and say, it's okay, this too shall pass. You know, we will be able to get past this, no weapon, whatever it is that you use to get motivated. So I do empathize with those people that may be going through it, but understanding that you can do it. I mean, that's what young people tell us. That's what, you know, anybody that has been through some sort of trial and tribulation get on these platforms and they say, I've been through this, 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 and this, and you can do it too. You know, whatever it is, I think that you can certainly set your mind a goal, a line here, and be able to overcome whatever is here and get it done. I mean, I just think that, you know, and the word manifestation is huge.
Right.
Because that part of it is when you actually lean into it and be able to really, really decide that this is what I'm going to go conquer. This is what I'm going to have. It begins to manifest because you're moving towards that common goal. You know, you're moving towards that. So I think that those things are important, affirmations. So maybe that's the next, that's the next line where it's just a bunch of words. I need the first one. I need a bunch of words all over it that just give you that.
I'll just say you're hitting. I'll be quiet, which is, but I'm not, seriously. I've shared with some people, like, this is something that's it didn't happen overnight. It may have seemed like it has been months in the planning, or I guess you could say technically 2 years in the planning, because this was a relaunch. For one, but what you hit upon, that's something that's part of our longer range plans that'll be dropping next year. So yeah, it's not, I you know how people paint a picture of you that they want, they paint a vision of you.
There we go with the they.
Yeah, that they or individuals. And like, oh, Brian, you're just a designer. You just draw cars. You just like, no. We, you know, I can sit here and talk about the injustices in our world. I can sit here and talk about like how we need to come together and uplift the Black wealth in the community. The apparel specifically, it's not just Panther themed. There are other affirmations that are coming. So, you know, you gotta have a long range plan and strategy. And that's one thing that I pride myself in. Hopefully I'm sure I haven't covered everything, and the team together, we haven't covered everything, but we've tried our best. And that one of the things you've hit on is hitting real close to what's coming in 2021. So
make it plain, write it and make it plain. And then you can work from there.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And that's what's important, because sometimes, like you say, you're a creative, you're a creator. So those things, that pen off the page could happen at any time. And that's my favorite term. I love pen off the page, but it could happen at any time. It could be anything that leads you, you know, to a different direction that speaks to the children, that speaks to anything that you've actually experienced, and being able to grow the line and, you know, have, you know, extreme success. One more time, give us that website for your line and your Instagram.
Absolutely. BrianYoungCreative.com is website where anybody can go. And we're constantly adding new apparel, like, so, you know, divisions or brands. And also, it's going to be expanding. I've had a ton of requests for my artwork and prints, not prints, but prints, but still that's ongoing, trying to find the right quality. But all basically the website will be expanding, but that's BrianYoungCreative.com. Instagram is Brian Young Creative. And that's pretty simple. Between those two, people should be able to get a hold of me. Yeah.
And I guess, you know, now that we're all family, I'm going to wait and get my holiday sweater next year, I guess. I mean, hopefully I can get it by like October or something, you know. Ooh. I mean, it's not that far away.
Oh, man. Oh, my bad. I'm hurt. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
I mean, October, next year, we got enough time for that. You know, call me if you need an inspiration. Yeah. I can push you through it, whatever you need.
Oh, I got some ideas. It was just the timing.
I know. I'm great with timing. I mean, it's just, but it's no harm, you guys. It's just, I have so many things going on that I don't always think of things in the time in which I try. Like, I know the big holidays, I know X, Y, and Z, but I mean, in my daytime, I do real estate. So I'm a developer by day, despite what anyone would know from this part of it. So I'm running construction teams and, you know, there's a whole nother situation there. So these things just allow for me to use my right brain. And, you know, when it comes to this, it's just like, oh, I can do this. Oh, let's ask Brian for a sweater tomorrow. Will that happen? Sorry.
I would say one of my, I was told like one of my Brianisms is, if I cut out sleep, then maybe I can get, man, I've been doing that for some time now. Like, I pulled an all-nighter Sunday night, and the other time I've done it. There's a difference when you're 20 doing it than when you're, you know,
Don't you feel it now? You're like, I'm going to either watch this movie or I'm going to go to bed, and I think I'm going to go to bed. My body is like, yo. I know you are having a good time, whatever you're doing, but I'm gonna need you to go sleep because this is just not that. And just for the record, that like 2 a.m., 3 a.m., 4 a.m., it's just not a good time for me because I'm so into like it's sleep. You catch me at 1 maybe, but rest of the time, you better get me at 6 in the morning because that middle of the road is like,
So you're an early bird.
I try to be because my construction teams are out at that time. So I have that. But it's just, I used to be, you know, when we hung out, you could hang out in the middle of the night and you'll be up till 3 or 4 in the morning. The sun is coming up. You just driving home, hoping you're not going to get bussed out or locked out, whatever it is. But... Yeah. That was just a few years ago. I can't do it now.
See, I told you 25.
At 25, that's right. Yeah. I was doing that. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Christmas music. What do you like? Holiday music.
Well,
you gotta have something.
two of my favorites, but actually the one that if you will allow me to play it, I have it spooled up.
Listen, we're having a good time. Play it,
man. So I won't go with the obvious one that is my favorite and everybody, Donny Hathaway, This Christmas. But the one that the more I listen to it, I laugh and I smile, and especially this person. As she went on later on in a movie, Eartha Kitt, Santa Baby.
Okay.
So, yeah, let me see. Because she's talking about, I need a convertible, light blue. And I'm like, and then she what?
That's for the snow. That's for the sickles. Remember, you just said you needed that illumination.
Yeah. She what else? She needs a deed? I'm like, man. Ooh. I'm sitting up here. Like,
oh yes, oh, that's sweet.
What tree do you want all the stuff under? Good Lord, girl.
A lady after my own heart.
But you know what? 54 convertible. Light blue. I could get behind the car, okay. But then she started going into a yacht.
That's it.
I'm like, man,
I'm down for it. We gotta get her on.
And this is back in the day when you dressed up to go to a house party. So to me,
they dressed up to go anywhere, to the grocery store.
Anywhere.
Yeah.
You know, so it's not just boom 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 Santa baby.
Yes.
Now I feel like I should like being a smoky jazz club with Frank Sinatra.
Next time. We go. Yes. Gotta set the mood. That's it. But that's an awesome song. That's a great selection.
You know, that reminds me, you know, Christmas, okay.
That felt good. That was really good.
Get me sentimental. This time of year, man, it just, you know, you think of family, you think of the end of a year, begin, you know, a fresh slate going into a new year. And that song reminds me of my childhood. And every summer I spent with my grandparents down in Tennessee and between that and Alabama. And but my dad's parents, they were pillars of their community. And they were in, I call it, you know, remember, okay, some people may clown me for this, but Fred Flintstone had, what was that? Him and Barney had the grand poobah with the hat. Uh-huh. My grandfather in Kingsport, Tennessee, there was it was called the Merrymakers Club. And so they would have like, they would that's dress it. Up in their tuxes. And I'm sitting there like, as a little kid, and then they'd have these shindigs and tuxedos. And around Christmas time, when we'd go down south for Christmas, see my
great
grandma.
Feelings, right?
Yeah. And that, you know, so it's Christmas, it's family, and, you know, it's a new beginning. We're celebrating Christ, and we're celebrating those that we love and are giving. And so, yeah, and that just takes me back. Yeah, that just takes me back in a different way. And like I said, the comical part, I'm like, man, she asked you for a lot. What do you do? What are you bringing to the party?
It's okay. She made it happen. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, we have Brian Young, the creative. We thank you so, so much for joining us on Champagne and Conversations. And I'm not going to say a word more because he left it at where we should leave it, which is the meaning of this holiday season. We want all of you all to stay encouraged. We want all of you all to know that there's love, and we wish you a happy holiday. And I am going to leave you guys. He is still pouring, and we are going to cheers to another holiday season.
Woo! Yes.
Oh. Now this is my favorite.
Yeah,
I listen to this every day.
We're gonna have to talk offline. That you can see my Christmas playlist. That's
this is Voice to Men. Yes.
Yes, with Brian McKnight in there too. Now, don't sleep on Brian
McKnight. I'm sorry. I just
Voice to Men with fellow Brian in there. So
fellow Brian. Yes. Thank you all. Happy holidays.
Yeah, all right now. All right, sister. Cheers.